So in late 2019, we launched our first app store, which was inspired by the company's mission to empower the world to design. And we wanted to do this in the Canva way, which was to create an API and make app development as simple as possible for each part of the design process. At the heart of this app store, we built the extensions, which is a plugin model that allowed app developers to extend three essential design activities. First, with content extensions, users could import images, videos, embeds into their designs from any source, such as Google Drive or Typeform, and my personal favorite, Giphy. And who doesn't like Terry Crews GIFs scattered all over their presentations? I was going to put it on every slide, but that would be distracting. Then, with edit extensions, we enabled users to edit raster or vector images off-platform, such as the incredibly successful background remover. And finally, publish extensions allowed users to publish their designs to any platform, such as Slack. Now, to build an app, a developer only needed to create a simple web service endpoint and app config, and then the plugin framework would take care of the rest. It would render the API in product and at the right time call the web service endpoint. Developers didn't have to build like sophisticated UIs or anything to bring their ideas to life. And this approach resulted in hundreds of apps, with a few very, very successful ones. But we weren't satisfied. Listening to our developers through interviews and our support channels, we realized that this approach did not offer enough flexibility. So we had the opportunity to push ourselves a lot harder to find a way to unleash the creativity of thousands of developers, everyone here today, and many more. So in order to do this, we needed to open up our platform to give access to flexible and powerful APIs that can be composed into rich apps. APIs should be interoperable so that they can be mixed and matched within a single app. We should enable developers to have maximum control of the app's user interface, and finally expose many, many of the key user interactions of the product over time, such as any user interaction they do in the design. This approach allowed us to go from apps that only we could imagine to apps that could enable anything our creators could imagine by combining many different APIs, such as adding elements, replacing elements, uploading media, making service calls, and much, much more. So at the highest level, we have a few things. The app built by the developer and the Canva editor that contains the product features and the app framework itself. An app is a JavaScript bundle that loads into a sandbox iframe, and this sandbox protects our users and the Canva product from potentially unsafe code, such as leaking sensitive user information or corrupting designs. Apps then communicate to our various APIs that are available inside the sandbox. And then, if you look under the hood, these APIs communicate to a message bus that marshals calls back and forth between the Canva experience and the app. The message bus speaks to an app controller, and this app controller is a great place where we can absorb breaking changes in from our product teams, ensure that the product teams can evolve independently from our API. Now, to get this product started, we realized its daunting scope. We needed to build a stable, secure, sandboxed environment with a brand new build and deploy pipeline, complete with a new SDK, a seamless developer experience that doesn't introduce any breaking changes. And delivering everything at once meant that it would take a very, very long time before we could get anything to our app developers. So we decided to dream big and start small by iterating on the app framework over a period of a year. And this to ensure that we can get something into our developers' hands early and get that valuable feedback. But we knew that this iterative approach would also cost us like a lot of development effort. But that was okay because we would learn as we go. By applying pragmatic excellence, we started hosting the app SDK in a simple S3 bucket, which was a quick solution and required a lot of manual work to get us up and running, stable and secure. Also meant that we couldn't leverage that platform that Brendan had spoken about earlier to its fullest extent, giving us like automated build checks, rollback, clarity on who changed what, unified type checking, and flexible security. The seemingly dirty approach also raised questions from a lot of the non-API Canva engineers because we didn't leverage the full platform. But they first sought to understand the why behind our approach before critiquing it. And that enabled us to overcome a lot of dependencies in our project. So collaborations like these lie at the heart of our value to work with empathy, humility, and generosity. And all of this extra work definitely had a price, but it allowed us to rapidly prove the core apps SDK with our internal releases, like the hackathons, and our preview releases. So once we were there and we proved the core app SDK, we could now start adding more sophistication. We started adding a gateway service to serve up our apps, which made sure that we could leverage the Canva infrastructure, and that enabled us to leverage our infrastructure tooling and security policies and all of those wonderful things. It also enabled us to introduce automated builds to improve checks, rollbacks, audit logs, and finally, it allowed us to improve our type checking for API messages, and that allowed us to simplify backwards compatibility and deprecation. And the combination of these facilities make development completely flexible within our product. And also, it allows our teams to deploy new APIs without breaking existing versions of those APIs. So looking into the future, our next steps is to introduce manifests to make our apps more portable, and then start working on command line tooling, because who doesn't love working on the command line?